Hello again and welcome back to our course on PowerPoint 2013. In this section we're going to take a look at touch in relation to PowerPoint 2013, and largely speaking that means looking at touch in relation to Office 2013 at this stage. I mentioned earlier that one of the major new features of Office 2013 is extended support for touchscreen devices, so the use of touch is a very important aspect of this new version of PowerPoint. I also mentioned earlier that by default on this course I'm going to be using mouse and keyboard, but whenever something new or different occurs that affects the use of PowerPoint 2013 using touch, I will go through that, and also from time to time I will use touch as an alternative means of interacting with PowerPoint to perform specific tasks. Now, if you're planning to use touch, there are some very useful articles on Microsoft.com, both in terms of how to use touch with Windows in general and specifically about the use of touch in Office 2013. There's also some information in the Office 2013 help, but more of that in a little while. This particular article that I'm looking at here, which is actually about the use of touch in Windows, is a particularly good one because it talks about a keen user and their experience of using touch to perform particular tasks and the sort of things that work and the sort of things that maybe don't work so well. So some of those sources you should find very useful. Now, in many cases, the way that you would use touch instead of a keyboard and mouse to perform a task in PowerPoint 2013 is a pretty straightforward swap, where I say click, then with a touchscreen device you would tap. And that's a pretty good basis on which to work. However, there are quite a few situations in which click and tap, although nominally performing the same function, will actually achieve different results. And very often the way that PowerPoint reacts to tap instead of click is either subtly different or in some cases is quite different. So things like the indicators that you see on the screen, the information say about making a selection, is different on a touchscreen device to the information that you get when you're using keyboard and mouse. So even if on the face of it what you're doing with a touchscreen device is the same as what you're doing with a keyboard and mouse, what you see in the process may be quite different. Now let me give you a particular example of that. Now don't worry about everything that you can see here, I'll be explaining this to you later. I just want to demonstrate within PowerPoint, this is a single slide in PowerPoint, what I mean by the equivalence and differences comparing mouse and keyboard with touch. This slide has some text on it at the top, behavioral chain of responsibility, and then some text here, and then down here we have a picture. Now if I click with the mouse on that picture, it becomes selected. Note that it's got a sort of frame around it with these little handles on the corners and a little rotation control at the top there. If I click on it again, nothing happens. It's selected and I can choose to do things with it or not, as the case may be. If I just click outside the slide and start again, let me now touch with my finger on the picture, and note it's done exactly the same thing, it's selected that picture. But let me now touch with my finger again on the selected picture. And what I see is a little toolbar that comes up with options like cut, copy, delete, style, etc. Although in the end what you can do with a touch device and what you can do with mouse and keyboard are going to be exactly the same for this picture, the processes, the things that appear, the tools, the commands, the information about what's going on will differ in many cases. So although it's true to say that you can do the same things with both, the route while you're doing that and the information you get while you're doing that may be different between the two approaches. So as we work through this course on PowerPoint 2013, I'll be aiming to cover these very specific gestures with a touch device, and not only covering how to do things using a touch device, but also pointing out some of the differences where they occur with mouse and keyboard. And although the default will be mouse and keyboard throughout, I'll aim to give adequate coverage for those of you wanting to use touch devices that you're going to be confident in using PowerPoint 2013. Now, if you're planning to use Touch with PowerPoint 2013, I suggest you look at one or two of the very good articles on office.com about the use of Touch with Office. And the one that you can see here is a particularly good one, because not only does it explain some of the basic aspects of using Touch with Microsoft Office, but it gives some of the background. And if you're interested in understanding why things work the way they do, this is a very good article to start with. It also contains one or two particularly useful sections. One section contains a very useful explanation of why one of the key aspects of implementing Touch for Office 2013 was to space certain things out more. For instance, we'll see later on that with the ribbon, if you work in Touch mode, everything is spaced out more, as in the lower diagram here. And the basic reason for this is pretty straightforward, and that is that if you're operating something with your fingers, particularly if you've got fat fingers like mine, tend to need more space to operate than clicking with a mouse. And this is a recurring aspect of the way that Office 2013 has been redesigned to support the use of touch. Another very useful section in that article explains how text and object selection works, and how the little selection handles that you see if you're using a touch device are different and work in a subtly different way to the ones that you see when you're using keyboard and mouse. And one other very important aspect of using a touch device is that when you do need to enter text, and if you're using a keyboard, whether you're using a physical attached keyboard or whether you're using a virtual keyboard, there are differences in how this works. For example, between Windows 7 and Windows 8. It's not possible for me to cover every possible way that you might use a keyboard at every point in the course, but one or two points the issue of a virtual keyboard will come up, and I'll be assuming that whatever device you're using, you're able to enter text without difficulty. So that's the end of the sort of background information about PowerPoint 2013. It's time to start making some presentations. So I'll see you in the next section.
If this is your first time here, click on the subscribe button to get similar videos every week. Every Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday, new videos are uploaded to our YouTube channel. If you want to see similar videos, click on the links under Check Out These Tutorials by Simon Says It.